فلله الحمد رب السماوات ورب الأرض رب العالمين.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين، وبعد، إن شاء الله تعالى we will continue our class Al-Aqeedat Al-Wasitiyyah. Our class stopped last time. قوله جل وعلا وتوكل على الحي الذي لا يموت وقوله وهو الحكيم الخبير. We will benefit so many benefits related to the attributes of Allah, His names and His qualities. Allah is a Hayy, Allah is Qayyum, Allah is Hakim, Allah is Khabir. All these are names and attributes which belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. Today we will start قوله تعالى يعلم ما يلج في الأرض وما يخرج منها وما ينزل من السماء وما يعرج فيها وهو معكم أينما كنتم والله بما تعملون بصير وعنده مفاتح الغيب لا يعلمها إلا هو ويعلم ما في البر والبحر وما تسقط من ورقة إلا يعلمها ولا حبة في ظلمات الأرض ولا رطب ولا يابس إلا في كتاب مبين وقوله جل وعلا وما تحمل من أنثى ولا تضع إلا بعلمه وقوله جل وعلا لتعلموا أن الله على كل شيء قدير وأن الله قد أحاط بكل شيء علما. Shaykh has quoted these verses from the Quran, which indicates and affirms to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the sifat al-ilm, the knowledge of Allah azza wa jal. And the knowledge of Allah subhanahu azza wa jal is perfect knowledge. Okay? And his knowledge encompasses everything. Nothing can be outside of the knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Nothing. Everything in the knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa azza wa jal. Allah sees everything. Allah controls everything. Allah knows everything where it is. Heaven or earth. Subhanahu Azza wa Jal. So that sifat al-ilm is a sifa that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala belongs to him. Alim al-ghaybi wa shahada. Right? So when we attribute to Allah knowledge, when we give him name of alim, that is something belongs to him. We said to the human being, alim. We said we have ilm. So when we say this person is a alim, and we say Allah is a alim, it doesn't mean that they are equal. No, our knowledge is very limited. The knowledge of Allah is perfect, encompasses everything. Our knowledge is very, very limited. وَمَا أُوتِيتُم مِّنَ الْعِلْمِ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا. Allah says subhanahu wa ta'ala, yeah, you are not given from the knowledge except a few things. Very few of knowledge that you have as a human being. So don't think that you really know everything. طيب. So that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned this ayat, how his ilm encompasses everything. So we start this ayah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, يَعْلَمُ مَا يَلِجُ فِي الْأَرْضِ. Allah knows wherever enters into earth. وَيَعْلَمُ مَا يَخْرُجُ وَمَا يَخْرُجُ مِنْهَا. And everything that which comes forth from the earth. What does it mean? Everything goes into earth, including, rain falls. Every drop goes in this earth. Allah knows subhanahu wa ta'ala. Can we count these raindrops? Subhanallah, mustahil. It's impossible. But the knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what? He knows it and was counted and was put in a book. Every drop. Okay? Tayyib. He knows all the minerals, very, very good things that the earth contains. Petrol, minerals, rocks, sands, iron, gold, everything. Allah knows subhanahu wa ta'ala. Okay? Who knows that? Who can claim that they know everything about the earth? Every cent, every piece of dust, Allah knows subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yeah? So that's the knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ilmullah azza wa jal. وَمَا يَنزِلُ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ وَمَا يَعْرُجُ فِيهَا. Subhanallah. As well as the heavens. Allah knows everything in earth. So like He knows everything that in heavens. Whatever goes into the heavens, and whatever comes out and comes down from the earth. وَمَا يَنزِلُ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ. So many things comes down from the heavens. The first one is what? The angels. They came from the heavens and they visit this earth, this planet. The angels are visiting us every single day. They are with us. They are so many. They have different jobs. لَهُمْ مُعَقِّبَاتٌ مِنْ بَيْنِ يَدَيْهُ مِنْ خَلْفِهِ يَحْفَظُونَهُ مِنْ أَمْرِ اللَّهِ. Some angels, they stay with us and they are keep the record, our action and our saying and whatever we do, they keep put them in record, right? Some angels, they came two shifts. Prophet ﷺ said there is a two shift for the angels. يَتَعَاقَبُونَ فِيكُمْ مَلَائِكَةٌ بِاللَّيْلِ وَمَلَائِكَةٌ بِالنَّهَارِ. There is rotation between two angels. Those who come from the night shift and day shift, he said. And they switch from the Fajr, Salatul Fajr and Salatul Asr. One group comes in Salatul Fajr and they stay until Salatul Asr. The other group came to Salatul Asr and they stay until Salatul Fajr. And that's the way. They come to the masajid. And Allah will ask them, how did you lift my servants? And they will say, تَرَكْنَاهُمْ وَهُمْ يُسَلُّونَ وَأَتَيْنَاهُمْ وَهُمْ يُسَلُّونَ. We will left them while they were praying Salatul Asr. And we go to them while they were praying Salatul Fajr. So he said, try that you really pray these two salawat. Salatul Fajr and Salat Al-Asr. Because the time of these angels changing each other and they take their report. Right? وَمَا يَنزِلُ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ. Also the rain comes from the sky. Okay? So many things. وَمَا يَعْرُجُ فِيهَا. And things that ascends and goes toward the heavens. The same thing. Angels, they will leave this planet and they go to the heavens. Also, our deeds, our a'mal, that we do as a human being, when these angels collect all these records, they go to the heavens. and they will report to Allah subhanahu azza wa jalla. وَهُوَ أَعْلَمُ بِهِمْ. They will report Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why? Allah knows better than what they tell him. Subhanahu azza wa jalla. Okay? See the ilm Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He knows everything in earth, whatever enters into the earth, whatever comes out. Heavens, whatever, you know, ascends, and whatever that descends from the heavens. On top of that, وَهُوَ مَعَكُمْ أَيْنَمَا كُنْتُمْ. وَهُوَ إِشْ مَعَكُمْ. Allah is with you. أَيْنَمَا كُنْتُمْ. Whenever you may be, wherever you may be. Because وَاللَّهُ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ بَصِيرٌ. And he said, everything that you're doing, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is a basir. I see everything that we do. طيب. This ayah contains and explains the knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَهُوَ مَعَكُمْ. This is ma'iyyah. This ma'iyyah has so much talk, so much explanation, and Shaykh will explain al-ma'iyyah inshallah later on. But this ayah, the Shaykh, he has quoted it to affirm the sifatul ilm lillahi subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sifatul ilm lillahi azza wa jal. And the knowledge of Allah is really encompasses everything. لا يعزب عنه مثقال ذرة في الأرض ولا في السماء. Nothing we can hide and escape the knowledge of Allah, even they may be in a item of weight. If they are really as small as one item, they not escape from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. طيب. هذا علم الله سبحانه عز وجل. So the Ahl al-Sunnah wal-Jama'ah, they affirm to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sifatul ilm wa annahu alim bi'ilmihi subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa rabada mu'tazila, you know their manhaj. Ithbatul asma wa nafyu sifat. They said he's a alim bila ilm. They affirm the name, but they won't deny the sifa. They say he's an alim bila ilm. How you can understand that? You can't get that one into our mind. No one can even, you know, subhanallah. طيب. أشاعرة الأشعرية والماتريدية, they said sifat al-ilm. They affirmed to Allah sifat al-ilm. They said, huwa alim bi'ilmihi. Like Ahl al-Sunnah. See? Asha'ira mutanaqidun. They contradict themselves. So many sifat they affirm like Ahl al-Sunnah. And then another aspect, they will deny the sifat. So the ulama, they said, what? How you could do this? If you really affirm to Allah some sifat, you have to go all the sifat like that. Or you deny all of them. But there is no way to affirm Allah some sifat and to deny some others. It's wrong. وَاللَّهُ بِمَا تَعْمَلْ بَصِيرٌ وَعِنْدَهُ مَفَاتِحُ الْغَيْبِ. The second ayah, which contains the ilm of Allah, Allah's knowledge subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَعِنْدَهُ مَفَاتِحُ الْغَيْبِ لَا يَعْلَمُهَا إِلَّا هُوَ. Yeah. With him, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the keys of the al-ghayb, unseen, hidden things. There's hidden things, there are unseen knowledge and things. No one has the keys except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. La ya'lamuha illa hu. Unseen things, no one knows. No one has a knowledge about them except Allah subhanahu azza wa jalla. So what we know as a human being is very limited. There is unseen things. There is an unseen world. Unseen life. Unseen creatures. and seen so many things. Allah Azza wa Jalla said, the keys of these things belong to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he negated, after he affirmed to himself, he negated from the creation. He said, لا يعلمها إلا هو. What he said, مفاتح الغيب لا يعلمها إلا هو. So since Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, لا يعلمها إلا هو, if someone came and said, I have knowledge about the unseen, he claims that he has the knowledge about al-ghayb, that person, what is going to be his role? He affirmed to himself that he has knowledge about al-ghayb. And Allah said in the Quran, لا يعلمها إلا هو. No one knows except Allah. طيب.
The hadith which says the keys of the knowledge of unseen are خمسة.
نعم.
And the categories that are mentioned therein, and as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, لا يعلمها إلا هو. But how do the ulama explain this hadith? Because considering what the wombs have, like for example, some people may say, okay, we know it's, you know, if it's a boy or if it's a girl or it's, you know, some other that matters. So how do the ulama explain these things?
The scholars, they said a lot of things. There's a stage. There's a, no human being can know it. Okay. And some stage, you know, other than Allah could know it. Except when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put the womb in a mother, you know, this feeder, this imperial, the angel Allah will send him and tells him what he's going to look like, what is going to be his future, what is going to be. So some creation may have a knowledge about it. Since it's not going to be remained anymore, ghayb, also other creatures may have a knowledge through the knowledge Allah gave them to know it. So the scholars, they said about this, since Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave the knowledge of it to the angels, they are creation of Allah. Also, it's not going to be forbidden for the human being also to have a knowledge about the, you know, what is going in the womb. Allahu a'lam. So the hadith said in related ayah, مفاتح الغيب خمسة. The keys of the غيب are five. In ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وعنده مفاتح الغيب لا يعلمها إلا هو. في another ayah, what is it? إن الله عنده علم الساعة. No one can claim what this world is going to become to end. We know this world will never, it's not ever exist. It's going to collapse and go to die. But no one knows. It has fixed time in the sight of Allah. When the hour came, all this world is going to vanish. But no one has that knowledge except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He did not even tell the angels. He did not tell the prophets and messengers. No one has a knowledge about it. So no one can claim. In America, so many times we see people claiming that they have a knowledge about the hour. Hey people, you live in this world. 2008, everybody's going to die. Oh, 2015, the end of the world. I have prophecy. Subhanallah. لا يعلمها إلا هو. وينزل الغيث ويعلم ما في الأرحام وما تدري نفس ما تكسب غدا. يعني what time is going to become the rain? Allah knows subhanahu wa ta'ala. وما تدري نفس ما تكسب غدا. You don't know what's going to happen to you next day, tomorrow. Is there anybody can predict it? What you're gonna face in tomorrow or the minute after this minute? No, Allah knows only. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sees his future, your future, like he sees your past, same together. In order to us, there is a past and present and future. For Allah is the same for subhanahu wa ta'ala. He sees your future like he sees your past. Same. Subhanahu azza wa jal. طيب. وما تدري نفس بأي أرض تموت. No one knows where he's going to die. Where his grave was prepared. So many people are leaving their home or their country in order to die another place. Okay. There is a story they mentioned. I don't know if it's Israeliyat or I don't know. We don't want to spend more time, but Nabiullah Sulaiman, he used to have one of his cabinet. He was in Jerusalem, in Quds. And the angel of Malakul Maud used to come and sit with the Nabiullah Sulaiman and talk to him. And one day, the angel of death came and sit with the Nabiullah Sulaiman, and he started just Malakul Maud looking at this, the one of the cabinet of the Sulaiman. Why? He looks at him like this all the time. And this man says, why is watching me like this? This guy keep watching me this way, why? After he left Malakul Maud, he came to the Nabiullah Sulaiman and said, who was that guy of time watching me? Oh, that was Malakul Maud. Oh, he's scared. He said, please, Nabiullah Sulaiman, take me. Take me another country. I don't want to stay here because this is Malakul Maud. He has really looked at me so badly. And okay, he gave order the wind that Allah gave him. And took him to the Indian. Woo, this guy went Bombay, is that? Sitting there. As soon as he arrived in Bombay, the angel of death is there and catches him up, though. It takes him up. And he died. He was digging his grave out there and he was buried out there. And Malakul Maud came back to Sulaiman and said again, oh, where you were? Because you were looking at my friend so badly. You know why when I was looking at him? Because his order was to die in India. And this guy sitting this time here. How he can get to India? And then as soon as I get the place, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tell me to take his life. The man was arrived, he said. This is amazing. Allahu a'lam. That's the story they mentioned. But no one knows. Where are you going to die? Allahu A'lam subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now. So that's the ilm of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No one can claim that. What about the physical world? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَيَعْلَمُ مَا فِي الْبَرِّ وَالْبَحْرِ. Allah knows everything that in Barr. Barr is his land. This planet are two parts. The water, which is oceans, and the land, dry part. Each of them, they have different creatures, different things. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Allah knows, has a knowledge, all of the whatever is in the land, and that which in the ocean, al-bahr, same thing. Subhanallah. And more than that, وَمَا تَسْقُطُ مِنْ وَرَقَةٍ إِلَّا يَعْلَمُهَا. No leaves falls down from its tree except Allah knows subhanahu wa ta'ala the time that leaves goes down. Subhanallah. How many billion leaves are dropping every single minute? We cannot even imagine. See Allah's knowledge subhanahu wa ta'ala. He has all this. He knows. He gave time. Every single leaf, the time they leave and the time they die, the time they drop from the trees. Everything controlled in the knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلَا حَبَّةٍ فِي ظُلُمَاتِ الْأَرْضِ. No grain, one grain, single grain. in the darkness of the earth. وَلَا رَطْبٍ وَلَا يَابِسٍ. No fresh things and no dry things, except إِلَّا فِي كِتَابٍ مُبِينٍ. That they, all of them was written in a book. Not only knowledge, they were recorded. They have name and number and proper place. Subhanallah. You know that these days, those companies who has a huge warehouse and they sell so many parts, they put everything in a computer and they put them serial number and barcode and everything. So once they want to get some piece of the parts that they want, no matter how small it is, they know where to go because in the computer, because in the record. Hey, go that shelf and that one, they pick the piece and bring it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us right now, His knowledge for everything is in record, it's in number. And He knows subhanahu wa ta'ala where they are, and that it won't lose anything. No grain, no fresh things, no dry things, everything in record. La ilaha illallah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the sifat al-ilm lillahi subhanahu wa ta'ala encompasses for everything. That's why we see that how these deviant groups, philosophers and Mu'tazila and so on, went astray when they attribute to Allah that He does not know something that happens in this world. They say Allah does not know what we're doing until we do it. نفاة القدر والعياذ بالله. وقوله وما تحمل من أنثى ولا تضع إلا بعلمه. وما تحمل من أنثى. No female conceives. ولا تضع. Not to deliver what she has conceived. Except the knowledge of Allah. إلا بعلمه. The أنثى here is not only human being. How many females are there? Everything in this world are male and female. Everything. Everything that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to stay and to produce over and over, it has to have what? This sifa. Sifa is az-zawjiyyah. Allah mentioned that in the Quran. Many places. Everything. وَمِنْ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ خَلَقْنَا زَوْجَيْنِ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَذَكَّرُونَ. وَمِنْ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ خَلَقْنَا زَوْجَيْنِ. Everything we create them as a pair, male and female, so they can, you know. So every female, it will be what? Pregnant by a male and deliver babies and so on. Whatever type you may be, Allah knows subhanahu wa ta'ala. Subhanallah. Whether they may be in the heavens, in the earth, in the oceans, and whatever. Subhanallah. That's the ilm Allah Azza wa Jalla. لِتَعْلَمُوا أَنَّ اللَّهَ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٌ وَأَنَّ اللَّهَ قَدْ حَاطَ بِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ عِلْمًا. In this ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, لِتَعْلَمُوا, to know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has ability over everything. The first sifa, sifatul ish, al-qudra. Ithbatul qudra lillahi subhanahu wa ta'ala. Affirmation for the attribute of qudra, the ability of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala over everything. Alright? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has ability over everything because He's the one who created them. No one, nothing can resist to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Okay? That's first. وَأَنَّ اللَّهَ قَدْ أَحَاطَ بِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ عِلْمًا. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, subhanahu azza wa jal,
has surrounded everything with a knowledge. So there's two sifat in this ayah. Sifat ish, the attribute of ability, the qudra of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We affirm to Allah that He is a qadir. Wa anna Allah ala kulli shayin qadir wa qadir wa muqtadir qudra ilahiyya subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa anna ilmahu subhanahu azza wa jal bi kulli shayin muhit. Wa anna Allah qad ahata bi kulli shayin ilma. Nothing can escape the knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Nothing that falls outside the knowledge of Allah azza wa jal. So we affirm two sifas, sifat al-ilm and sifat al-qudra. And both of them are really belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. Na'am. طيب. Now Shaykh said, وَقَوْلُهُ تَعَالَى إِنَّ اللَّهُ هُوَ الرَّزَّاقُ ذُو الْقُوَّةِ الْمَتِينِ. الآن Shaykh start talking about the صفات الله سبحانه وتعالى. We mentioned before صفة العلم, before صفة القدرة, before صفة الحياة, صفة القيومية, صفة ماذا أن الله حكيم وخبير. All these sifat, Shaykh continuously mentioned all these sifat that came in the Quran and Sunnah. Now he said, "Inna Allah ish, huwa ish al-Razzaq." Allah is the one who provides, the provider for His, you know, servants. Everything that Allah He created, they need really Allah Subhanahu wa Taala. Everything that Allah created, they cannot exist without Allah's, you know, provision. Even the mountains we see, dry mountains, this is steel. Everything, they will vanish if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not give the ability to stay. Subhanallah. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala take the power He gave them to stay solid, they will be dust. So everything exists because of the provision of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Everyone receives the provision of Allah according to his nature. As a human being, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us health, food to drink, oxygen that we inhale, you know, water to everything. That's the provision. If we don't get that, or if we don't have oxygen in 2 minutes, we die, all of us. So Allah is a Razzaq. Razzaq means fa'al. Ala wazn fa'al lil mubalagha. Mubalagha means he do that over and over and over. Subhanahu azza wa jal. Dhul quwwatil matin. Sifatul rizq, annahu raziq. And he said dhul quwwa. Dhul quwwa means ay sahibul quwwa. The owner of the power. Allah is the what? The owner of the all power. No one can claim the power. The owner of the power is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Tayyib. Al-Mateen al-Shadeed. The Al-Quwwat al-Mateen al-Shadeed. His power is very, very strong. He has excessive power. No one can challenge him subhanahu wa ta'ala. عز وجل. طيب. طيب. الله هو الرزاق ذو القوة المتين. إذن القوة من صفات الذات. صفة ذاتية. طيب. قوة وقدرة are same meaning. Allah is Qadir, Allah is Qawi, all of them are going to the same category. طيب. Al-Mateen alladhi lahu kamal al-quwwa. Mateen means his quwwa is perfect. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. طيب نعم وقوله ليس كمثله شيء وهو السميع البصير. In this ayah also Shaykh will affirm to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sifat al-sam wal-basar. Okay. Since we talked about Ahl al-Sunnah wal-Jama'ah, the way they affirm to Allah the sifat, sifat al-thubutiyya, sifat al-salbiyya, we talked all of it. Now we just start, you know, counting and mention the sifat Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sifat al-sam wal-basar was the dalil of hadhi al-ayah. Because we talked about this ayah so many times. Allah is Sami' has a Sam' which is suitable to Allah. Allah Basir has a Basar which is suitable to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah, they affirm to Allah all these sifat, sifat of that. Okay? They don't deny that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Sami'. They don't deny that Allah is Basir. Think about some other deviant groups. They don't affirm to Allah that he's Sami' al-Basir. Jahmiyyah, they are worst. They said, we cannot say Allah is Sami', we cannot say Allah is a Basir. Because Allah said in a human being, فَجَعَلْنَاهُ سَمِيعًا بَصِيرًا. So they said, if we said Allah is Sami' or Basir, we're just resembling to his creation. So they negate it. That's the, you know, the mistake they have, all the deviant groups. The Sam' and Basar belongs to Allah. ليس كمثل شيء. It's not like human beings at all. Now. وقوله إن الله نعم ما يعدكم به إن الله كان سميعا بصير. إن الله نعم ما يعدكم. Allah has promised you good things. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is al-sami' al-basir. فيه الدليل على أن صفة السمع غير صفة البصر. إذ العطف يقتضي المغايرة فالصفات بالنظر إلى الذات مترادفة لأنها كلها صفة الذات وواحدة بالنظر إلى الصفات المتباينة لكل صفة غير صفة. نعم. هكذا قال الشيخ رحمه الله. This ayah and the other ayahs are just affirmed to Allah the sifat al-sam' wal-basar haqiqa is a truth kama yaliqu bi jalali Allah wa adamatihi as Allah suitable to him subhanahu azza wa jal his sam' and his basar laysa kamithli shay wa qawluhu wa lawla id dakhalta jannataka qulta ma shaa Allah la quwwata illa billah wa law shaa Allah maqtatalu ولكن الله يفعل ما يريد نعم طيب this ayah إثبات إيش لمشيئة الله تعالى إذا دخلت جنة ولولا إذ دخلت جنتك when you enter into your garden and you should say ما شاء الله whatever Allah wills will be to existence, right? لا قوة إلا بالله. No one has a power except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to do everything. No one can do whatever he wants except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, his mashia. نعم. طيب. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we attribute to him that he has a mashi'ah. Mashi'ah means sifa that was to attribute to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to be, it will be. And it will be the time he wants. No one can change. No one can do anything without the mashi'at Allah Jalla wa Ala. To do something, you need time, you need makan, you need qudra, you need all this stuff. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not give you mashi'at to happen all this, it will never happen. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَمَا تَشَاءُونَ إِلَّا أَن يَشَاءَ اللَّهُ. The mashiatullah over our mashia. If you want to do something, you cannot do it unless Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you the go-ahead and provide for you the time and place and the qudra to do it. You won't be able to do it. Okay? So that's why Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah yuthbitun lillahi al-mashi'a. Wa anna mashi'atahu nafidah. If Allah wants something, it will happen. That's why min aqidat al-muslimin, aqidat Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah, ma sha'a Allah kana wa ma lam yasha' lam yakun. This is aqidah. Everything Allah wants, everything Allah has mashiyah on it, it will be, if Allah wants that. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mashiyah not to happen anything, it will never happen. So everything was dominated by ish, by the mashiyah of Allah jalla wa'ala. Now, so it's about sifat al-mashiyah, lillahi azza wa jalla. طيب ولو شاء الله ما اقتتلوا ولكن الله يفعل ما يريد. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was talking about the surah al-Baqarah, تلك الرسل فضلنا بعضهم على بعض الآخرين. Then he said in the end of the ayah, ولو شاء الله ما اقتتلوا ولكن الله يفعل ما يريد. Which means this ayah, but also the al-irada wal-mashi'a. Al-irada wal-mashi'a, kilahuma yadkul tahta mada wahid al-akhar. Kulluhum mada, ma arad Allahu kana, mashi'atuhu iradatuhu. Ma sha'a Allahu kawnan, kana. Wa ma sha'a Allahu shara'an, mada yakunu ala hasb al-insan. Hunaka إرادتان وهناك إيش ماذا مشيئة الله الكونية أو إرادة الله الكونية. الله سبحانه وتعالى whatever he wants to happen as a cone, this universe, it will happen and it will, no one can stop it. That is called what? الإرادة الكونية القدرية. Everything that Allah wants to happen in this world, it will happen and no one can stop. هذا ايش مشيئة ايش مشيئة والإرادة الكونية. والمشيئة والإرادة الشرعية هذا, for example, Allah wants to us as شرع not to disbelieve, not to commit zina, not to drink alcohol, not to, you know, do disobey him. That's shar. Irada ish al-shar'iyya. Irada al-shar'iyya, it happen or may not happen. Because he gave us free will to fulfill the al-irada al-shar'iyya. Okay? So if you really obey Allah, you will fulfill his irada al-shar'iyya. But there's no one can deny his irada al-kawniyya. You cannot deny the way you look. You cannot deny whether you be rich or poor. You cannot deny whether you be health or sick. This irada al-kawniyya. But a person may deny to pray. Or irada shar'iyya. So all the time we distinguish between two iradatain. Irada al-kawniyya, irada ish الشرعية. نعم. So the المشيئة والإرادة والقوة كلها إيش صفات الله سبحانه وتعالى, وأنه سبحانه عز وجل فعال لما يريد. فعال لما يريد. لو شاء الله سبحانه وتعالى عدم اقتتالهم لم يقتتلوا. شوف, these people they fight and they kill each other. Had Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala want not to fight, they couldn't fight. But the mashiatullah subhanahu wa ta'ala happened upon them and led them to fight. They fight. ولكن الله يفعل ما يريد. طيب. وقوله سبحانه وتعالى أحلت لكم بهيمة الأنعام إلا ما يتلى عليكم غير محل الصيد وأنتم حرم إن الله يحكم ما يريد. كل هذه الآيات تثبت صفة ماذا؟ المشيئة والإرادة، فعال لما يريد، وأنه سبحانه يحكم ما يريد. كل هذا بهيمة الأنعام، أحلت لكم بهيمة الأنعام، وليس بهيمة الأنعام، بهيمة الأنعام أي إيش؟ Four things: camel and cows and goat and sheep. These are four behemoth al-an'am. And every time Allah Subhanahu wa Taala talks about behemoth al-an'am, are these four? It's not included for, you know, wild animals or just like that. And whenever Allah Subhanahu wa Taala asks us to slaughter, you know, hadi or gift to the Kaaba or udhiyah or kada, it has to only be behemoth al-an'am only. No one can get a gazelle or impala or anything and then say, hey, I'm going to slaughter this. Right? Now, aywa. Uhillat lakum behemoth al-an'am. Behemoth al-an'am is halal. Alhamdulillah. Illa ma yutla alaykum, except what that was recited on you. Ghayra muhill al-sayd wa antum hurum. And also when a person goes to Hajj and he's in Ihram, it's haram upon him to hunt, you know, the animal in order to eat food. It's haram upon him. Why? Inna Allah yahkum ma yurid. This is rather the hukm of Allah, and he has irada to legislate what he wants, subhanahu wa ta'ala. لا يسأل عما يفعله يسألون. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala فعال لما يريد. يفعل بإرادته ومشيئته. يفعل بإرادته ومشيئته. Whatever Allah he wishes or he wants, no one can question him. لا يسأل عما إيش يفعل. But for us, وهم يسألون. Everything we do, everything we conduct, we have to prepare some answer for that, because Allah is going to question us about it. Now, طيب. إن الله يحكم ما يريد. على كل حال, this is الصفات التي ذكرها الشيخ, these attributes, العلم والقدرة والسمع والبصر والمشيئة والإرادة, all of them are just attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It belongs to Allah in the way suitable to Allah azza wa jal. Nothing will resemble to his creation, and all the sifat are just like that. Whatever Allah attributes himself or his messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam attributes to him, it will be something suitable to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Nothing like sifat al-makhluqeen. ليس كمثل شيء وسمع بصير. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.